this year. As with a number of Christman names, their origin and how they relate to each other can be a little confusing. So let me give it a try here, because my guess is some of you know him by either Stephen, anybody here, or Danny, right? So it goes both ways. Linda's maiden name is Stephen's, and so Linda and Bob named Carl Stephen Christman. But Linda eventually intended for the Stevens to make this way up to the first name. So for Danny, it became Stephen Daniel Christman. And the reason for the name Daniel was because Daniel designated strength. And if you've ever tried to arm wrestle Danny or Stephen, you got to feel some of that strength. I remember a few times back in the day. Good memories of Danny began right when he was born. It wasn't too far from here where early in the morning, things were starting to happen, and Bob got in the car with Linda, with Carl, and this high-speed thing started to happen here in Loma Linda, and everybody was having a good time. Bob was excited to be able to get to speed to the birthing center. The only sad thing there, he was probably disappointed that he didn't get pulled over and have a good excuse to share with the cop of the escort that he really would have appreciated the rest of the direction. When they arrived at the birthing center, it was just very a relaxing, peaceful place. The doctor, the nurse were all so friendly, welcoming. There was this play area for Carl, and Carl got to play with these new toys while wearing his Superman outfit for the day. The day had already been so well prepared. It's the picture perfect birthday. Linda had made some veggie burgers and had timed somewhere down prior to have made a impossible pie for everyone to enjoy. And so every good birth, you know, you have to have a picnic. And so that's exactly what happened. And what made the day even better was everyone got to go home right about 1 o'clock. And there you were, the family just started to grow. Perfect day. Really, the family came together in quite an amazing way. It came together actually kind of quickly once things started to roll. Danny came. Carl was alone, maybe happily alone for a while, but almost overnight there was 3 bunks, and Lonnie got to instantly enjoy her new role as her brother's manager. And she would be joined a little later by Kenny. And so began some really happy times. And I really wish I could have gotten a chance to kind of hear from some of you. You know, I know I didn't get a chance to visit with Kenny last night, and Gay, and some of the others, but let me share with you a little bit of what I heard last evening. When the kids were little, Bob and Linda bought a heavy-duty twin stroller. I believe it was Carl and Lonnie got a chance to maneuver this stroller on either side, taking the responsibility, while the two younger kids, Danny and Kenny, were in the middle. Just a memorable walk. It's the little things, right? There was this trip with this big van that Bob and Linda had purchased. The van was all decked out. And I remember our family had a similar van, the Vandura, and it had a bench in the back. You had a series of cabinets, even a sink, and all the kids got to, I think you guys all sat on the bench together. And there was even, every kid had their designated drawer to have their favorite toys for this trip along. And as Linda shared, what made it so awesome that day was that it was not just the fun, but that all the attention that everybody got to put on each other. Grandpa and Grandma were also there. When Danny was 5, another one of those memorable moments that just stand out happened when the family was at Blue Jay. Danny was out picking flowers, and he found this perfect flower, and he took it over to Mom, and with the biggest smile on his face, presented this little flower to you. And you said, Linda, he was just so caring. I think that kind of exemplifies a lot of who Danny was. Just very caring. He was so caring, in fact, and thoughtful and close to family that he said to his mom and dad, when I grow up, I want to live next door. You know, that was Danny. Danny liked having fun, too. He always ragged and treated Lonnie like a brother. He never let a good moment pass during that 1 month of the year when Lonnie and Danny shared the same birth or the same age, to where Danny could claim equaldom in the family with Lonnie. Danny and Lonnie enjoyed the post, what was it, when Bob became mayor, because there were some perks when Bob became mayor. And there was, I didn't know this until last time, but evidently there was a car that Bob got to drive around because of the city as a gift. And Lonnie and Danny would take this car occasionally, unbeknownst to Bob, for little joy rides at night, and brought it back safe and sound. But they had a lot of good times doing that. Danny did have one little fault, though, when having a good time, because he often had a hard time getting out of jams if he got caught. So, like the time he decided to borrow a car, and also borrow Carl's license to explain, and then having to explain to the cop after the difference in pictures after he got pulled over. That didn't go too well. Kenny and Danny were very close. And what I picked up from last night, Kenny, was that you knew when Danny and you were in a jam how to get out of trouble. That Danny just had a way of keeping talking as you quietly went about your business. Danny was known for a number of things. Danny never met a stranger. I remember the time that when David and Julie, one of our other cousins, got married, and Danny came up to Carrie and I and invited himself on our little trip to the Salt Lake in Salt Lake City. And that was the greatest thing. We felt comfortable enough and we had such a great time going out into the Salt Lake. And Danny and I were both on the heavier side, and we thought, man, is this salt water gonna hold us up? And sure enough, we were both sitting out there letting the water hold us up and having a great time. But it was as if whenever I saw Danny, it was as if we never lost a moment in between, you know? He had a way of making you feel close all the time. His ability to make friends was unparalleled. He always tried to help others. And then there was some of the other gifts that Danny had. The gift of being able to play the piano, play it by ear, compose songs, you know, and bless others with that. He drew and painted Most recently, he focused on decorative patterns and his drawings, and wrote some poetry. Danny was a good cook, although Christine gave me the impression last night that the good cook side was sometimes outweighed by the mess he left in the kitchen. And of course, he loved animals. This one carried over, you could easily see it, and his love for Buster, his dog, was a big deal. Danny had a big, big heart. We're gonna listen to a song, and then we're gonna be blessed by a poem.
If I had only known the last time would be the last time, I would have put off all the things I had to do. I would have stayed a little longer, held on a little tighter. Now what I'd give for one more day with you. Cause there's a wound here in my heart where something's missing. And they tell me that it's gone and healed with time. But I know you're in a place where all your wounds have been erased. And knowing yours are healed is healing mine. The only scars in heaven, it won't belong to me and you. There'll be no such thing as broken, and all the old will be made new. And the thought that makes me smile, is that the only scars in heaven are on the hands that hold you now. I know the road you walked was anything but easy. You picked up your share of scars along the way. But now you're standing in the sun. You fought your fight and your race is run. The pain is all a million miles away. The only scars in heaven, it won't belong to me and you. There'll be no such thing as broken, and all the old will be makes me smile now. Even as the tears fall down, is that the only scars in heaven, yeah, are on the hands that hold you now. Not a day goes by that I don't see you. You live on and on the better parts of me. Until I'm standing with you in the sun, I'll fight this fight and this race I'll run. Until I finally see what you can see. Oh, the only scars in heaven, such thing is broken, and all the old will be made new. And the thought that makes me smile now, and even as the tears fall down, is that the only scars in heaven are on the hands that hold.
shake. You should.
Danny will be surprised that among them, quite an assortment of tools and some artwork, but there was also a poem. I never knew that he wrote poetry. And as I was reading this, to see if it was something I could share, if this is what I needed to do, I realized that to me, it's like a goodbye from Danny. And there's some comfort in that. So I'm going to try to get the other one to you. As I watch the elegant, cascading dreams drip and slip just to fade into my elusive past, I can't help but wonder what is yet to come, or what I am to behold just beyond my grasp. What is it? Who is it to be withered, rotted, and decay away just outside my clasp? No memories of things that have come to pass, no poems or queries, nor do I neglect to nurture the lovers and the sinners. Those of you who know Danny know how true that is. Danny was there for anybody who needed him. As the flower petals wither and the sun drifts off into the universe in silver, the moon bears brilliant light, casting pearls of pure delight from her porcelain face as the day slips down deeper into the static echoes. And at the bottom he wrote, and I hope you have a nice day.
I know there's a lot of memories. Maybe they're coming into our mind right now, and stories or just thoughts, kind of maybe adjectives that describe Danny, what he meant to you, to us. And it's gotta be really nice. There's no pressure to share, but just if you would like to, we're just kind of go into a little time of sharing. Might be some times of silence when everybody just kind of collecting their thoughts, and you know, but just like to invite us just to share a little bit. You don't have to come up front, stand wherever you're at, but what comes to your mind when you're thinking of Danny today?
I'd like to share something. My name's Ruth. And I'm eternally blessed that so many of these handsome and beautiful ladies are a part of my family. I first met Kenny when he was about 15. And he became a fixture at my house, a welcome fixture. And I met Danny a couple years later. And never did he come in my home without a wonderful hug and open my piano and would just play his own compositions, and he could talk to me about anything. We had such a giggle. But you know, he was out there with the guys, and they get rowdy sometimes, but we had a wonderful time, and I considered all these people my family. The last time I saw him, he was sharing his notebook, his art with me, and a poem that I saw in there. And it was a quiet time, but you know, he was so inventive, he was so creative, and he had a huge heart, and he'll always be part of my heart. Thank you.
place that both of our lives. For me in particular, Christman had so many fans, and one of the fans that spent some time with us in Westchester, and he will go get groceries. But he'll come back with $100 worth of succulent plants, and one of the days he came with a big tree. It was a tiny little thing, telling how much did you pay for this? I said, it was only $40. Okay. So, the big tree has given through 2 years in a row now. So I was going to see what away, but when I learned of him, I think I will keep it as my memory of him. He was amazing. One time, Barry's car broke down, and he got on the internet, and in 3 hours flat, he had it fixed. I don't know. He knew how to fix anything. So, he will forever be in my heart.
Gay Christman, Danny's stepmom, and my daughter and I were talking. We came in from Arizona, and I was telling her that when we first, when Bob and I first got married, I think 2 months after we got married, she was pregnant, and she had a little baby boy named Daniel, and you could tell Danny liked babies or kids. And so I was, I think Brandon and Joe had gone out to eat. So I was watching Daniel, my first grandchild. And Danny was so excited. I mean, he just couldn't stop touching Daniel, and he had to be in there taking care of him. And Joe was a little concerned, and new dad, you know, that the baby's getting touched so much. And so Linda drove up in our driveway, and I don't know if you'll remember this, and I might tell it a little differently than it was, because it's my memory here. She drove up in the driveway, and then wanted to take Daniel out so Linda could see Daniel. And so, knowing how Joe was about Daniel, I'm a little concerned that he's going to walk out with this two-month-old baby and just show him off. And so he did, but I'm right behind him. Every step he's taking, I'm taking, because I'm so worried. And having to say, oh, well, we just dropped him or something. So, anyway, got out to the car. And I know Linda was saying how cute he was, and he was adorable. I wasn't, And got to see him. And it was just, you know, his happiness for such things as new babies and anything new in life. I mean, Daddy just had a heart. A big heart. Sometimes his big heart and the way I wanted to do things didn't always match, but he had a big heart for people. And so if somebody needed his last dollar, I'm sure Danny would have given him that and gone and got some